Hello and welcome to a fresh new edition of Creative Picks. This is Madhuvanti and this week I'll be reviewing marketing activations by Disney, Facebook and Ford Brazil. As Disney Plus gears up for its launch in November, Disney Network decided to share the excitement on Twitter 2 weeks back. And what followed was an engaging comment thread from its brands. So here's the synopsis. On August 19, Disney tweeted, "It's moving day. Is everyone packed and ready to go to Disney Plus? Pixar confirmed, but mentioned that in a shocking turn of events, it can't find Dory. National Geographic jumped in with its advice that was quintessentially Nat Geo style. But Dory was found as informed by Pixar. By the way, this is just the beginning. Soon Disney's other entities, the Marvel, the Avengers, Star Wars and the Guardians of Galaxy joined the bandwagon, confirming of their movement to Disney+. The entry of Guardians of Galaxy was my favorite. It tweeted with an image of the character Groot, captioned, "I am Groot." Disney Plus replied that it's barely 9 a.m. and we have already found Dory, assembled the Avengers and got Star Wars and Marvel to tweet at each other. It's just the most ambitious crossover event in history. All the tweets were posted in the span of half an hour. Smart tactic by Disney to build in the excitement for the upcoming Disney Plus with its offerings. They weaved in a short story and it was effective from the traction it generated. The first tweet itself was retweeted around 11,000 times. Someone even thanked Disney for making their day with this thread. ABC Entertainment and Simpsons also participated with their take on it. ESPN even remarked, "Talk about the ultimate lineup. This activity makes me wonder what other tricks Disney will have up its sleeves closer to the date." Nonetheless, we are waiting for it. So Facebook plans to open 5 pop-up cafes in the UK between August 28 and September 5, with the first one in London, as reported by Evening Standard. They are meant to help UK users to set up their privacy settings. This also includes what personal information is visible to others and what apps have access to their Facebook account. All this will be accompanied by free lattes and cappuccinos. So, what are these pop-up cafes for? As it turns out, they are a result of the finding of a recent poll conducted. It was revealed that 27% of London citizens don't know how to customize their social media privacy settings. So, the social media giant devised this method. It's a bizarre move if you ask me. Clearly, this is an attempt to convince its 2 billion users that it truly cares about their privacy. But how is setting up a cafe going to fix all the past damages, right from the Cambridge Analytica scandal that may have interfered with the 2016 US presidential election to the countless breaches and leaks? In fact, this news had hit the same week Facebook came under the fire for secretly accumulating transcripts of its users' messenger conversations. Facebook has to go beyond apologizing profusely for the mishaps and setting up cafes to safeguard the privacy and integrity of its users. In a basketball game, squeaking of shoes on the court is a soundtrack we are all accustomed to. Now imagine the game without that sound. Bit off. Too quiet. Well, Ford Brazil, the sponsor of the NBB, the Brazilian Basketball League, on Fox Sports and ESPN did just that. During the finals, the automobile company worked with the sound engineers to remove the sound squeaks from the match. It eliminated the sound on the court during 1 minute of every period. This is all part of its marketing gimmick with the ad agency GTB to promote its SUV EcoSport's advanced track and its electronic stability control technology that helps to prevent skidding on the streets. So every time the sound went off, the game announcer took this opportunity to talk about the car and its no sound experience. Meanwhile, an on-screen banner showed the car, its price, and the site where the people could read more about the technology.
Não tem jeito de imaginar. O som dos tênis na quadra, eles fazem parte do nosso dia a dia. Mais 2 pontos para o Flamengo.
E olha o Advanced Track em ação aí, hein? É a tecnologia de antiderrapagem do EcoSport que mantém você seguro na pista. Por isso que a Ford tirou o som dos tênis derrapando aqui na quadra para mostrar para você como ela funciona nas ruas. Thank you.
Talk about product placement. It's a smart technique for an automobile to work on the sound element to market its latest technology. It is a cost-effective way to get its TG's attention. But one shouldn't oversell, since the sound squeaking is integral to the soul of the game for the hardcore fans. On the other hand, if I come to think of it, it's an idea worth a shot in the Indian sports by the marketers across any category. Alright, that's a wrap on this episode of Creative Picks. Leave me your thoughts in the comments section below. And for your weekly dose of marketing and ad reviews, keep watching Creative Picks. See you next week.